Hey everybody, what's up? Killjoy Jake here, and instead of having friends, I have horror movies. Today we are talking about everything we know so far about the Five Nights at Freddy's movie. And there is a whole lot of history here that I'm going to be covering, so this is probably going to be a long video. I'm very excited to get into all this, but first I'm gonna need y'all to like this video and subscribe for more horror content. Subscribing really helps this page grow, it makes me happy, and it makes me cry a little less at night, so hopefully you do that. And if you want to prevent these threats that you see at the bottom of the screen here, you can support me on Patreon for just like $1 a month. You can check that out by clicking on the little link in the description below. Alrighty, now let's get into it.
What's your favorite scary movie?
Well, I'm Pennywise, the dancing clown.
Oh, no, not the beast! Not the beast!
You son of a...
God, don't do that.
Sometimes, that is better.
Alright. So Scott Cawthon, who is the creator of the Five Nights at Freddy's franchise, recently revealed earlier this year, so maybe not as recently as some other things we're going to be talking about here, that a Five Nights at Freddy's movie is finally in the works and going to be filming, well, right now. Less than a year after the release of the original game in 2014, so actually in 2015, they were trying to get production for some kind of movie adaptation, but unfortunately there was like all these failed scripts, all these directors who they like tried to get but like just weren't interested in making a movie like this, and things just weren't really going anywhere until 2017, when the production giant Blumhouse actually like stepped in and was like, hey, we're interested in making this movie. Because Blumhouse will make anything into a movie. 90% of the time, that's a good thing. But then there's that 10% of the time where it's like, wow, why did they make this? If you're curious about the 9 unused scripts for this movie, you can check out my buddy Chris's video from 3C Films. He talks about all of them and kind of like covers what those films would have been. I'm not going to talk about them because, well, they're not going to be using them. But if you want to learn a little more about those, you can check that out over on 3C Films page. So when Blumhouse stepped in 2017, they had a screenplay, but that has unfortunately also been scrapped. And like, I think they actually had a different director. Also didn't want to do it either. That basically set them all the way back to square one, where we were back in 2015, so like, what the hell's going on with this movie? Finally, in June of 2020, Jason Blum announced that progress was actually being made with the film. They had like some kind of screenplay written by Scott Cawthon. What is his fucking name? They finally had a screenplay written by Scott Cawthon, and like I said, that the progress with the movie was rapidly moving forward. And then earlier this month, Jason Blum promised us that a second annual Blumfest was coming in early October of this year, meaning we're gonna get some kind of huge update on the movie, as well as other Blumhouse projects like Insidious 5, during that event. If you don't know what Blumfest is, by the way, it's basically just like Comic-Con, but they just talk about all the Blumhouse movies over like live streams. And speaking about other Blumhouse projects, there's also this other movie coming out called Megan, but it's like instead of the E, there's like a 3. And I guess it's about like, it's just another killer doll movie, basically. It's gonna be very similar to Child's Play 2019. Blumhouse is producing it and like doing it, whatever. I am going to be talking about that. Obviously, like these videos where I put like a bunch of time into research, it's not just like off of one little update. Like I have to sit down and like read a bunch of articles, look up just like what's going on with the movie in general. Like these videos take a lot longer to make. Like I've been talking about doing this video for such a long time, and I've been kind of putting it off because there's been all these little updates on other things that I want to talk about. But eventually I will get to that and talk about it. I don't know anything about it right now, but soon. I really gotta chill with the side tangents. There's a lot of those in this video. Let's get back to the FNAF stuff though. Last year they announced Insidious 5 during it, and I think we're actually going to get like some kind of like trailer or release date something for it, which I'm really excited about. I'm also really excited about the FNAF movie too. I think we are definitely going to get a release date. I don't think it's coming out this year, unfortunately. We'll probably get like a release date, maybe like a poster or something. I don't think we're gonna get a trailer yet. It'll probably have a spring 2022 release date, is that's kind of what I'm speculating right now. That's kind of where I would think that they would release this movie. But then moving forward with some even more recent news. Jason Blum actually said in an interview that the most challenging part about doing this movie was trying to figure out the story, which obviously there's been like all these screenplays that were scrapped because it was like, what are we, like, we can't do this. This doesn't make any sense. And I totally see that. Like, look at Willy's Wonderland that came out earlier this year. The story is all over the place and some of the characters are very uninspired. Like, there's not really, like, really a whole lot of motivation for them being there besides just being body bags for these, like, for the animatronics to kill at some point. So the creator of FNAF, Scott, who I don't like saying his last name, recently took to Reddit and said that they're going to be using the Mike screenplay. Which basically in his post on Reddit, he said that it has, like, It's kind of a mix of all the other screenplays. He kind of took like the best things from all of them and smashed them all into this one story. Now, if you're curious as to why it's called the Mike screenplay, I had to do a lot of digging for this one. Now, if you remember from the first game, the main character's name is Mike Schmidt, but there is another Michael character that I didn't know about later on that is introduced, I guess, in the fourth game. He's like the little kid that you play as. But we could be talking about either Michaels here, because we have like a Mike Schmidt, who's like the main character of the first game, like I was saying. We also have the kid, Michael Afton? I think that's it. There we go. Now, he does specifically say the Mike screenplay, not the Michael screenplay, so like, I think it's maybe more talking about like that original character opposed to this like kid who gets deeper into the lore. Although, I would like to see this film explore some of the lore of the Five Nights at Freddy's game, because like, what would happen is if they just make another movie about a janitor who's battling animatronic robots, a lot of people are gonna see that and say, oh, this is just Willy's Wonderland, even though Willy's Wonderland copied FNAF. It's a bad situation that this movie is in, basically. So I think adding in like a totally different lore about how the animatronics came to life, like actually based off of some of the game's story, that's gonna make it a lot more interesting and very different. It's not a good situation that they're in because of Willy's Wonderland, but like, Nicolas Cage fighting animatronic robots. I mean, it's kind of hard to beat that. Scott wrote the screenplay for the film, and it's being directed by Chris Columbus. No, not the jackass that for some reason we had a national holiday of. I'm talking about the awesome film director. There's a big difference between those two characters. If you're unfamiliar with Chris Columbus's work, he did like the first Harry Potter movie, and I believe he did both of the Home Alone films. And don't even comment that there's other Home Alone films. There's not. There's Home Alone 3 does not exist. I'm really excited for the FNAF movie. My biggest worry though about it is like, obviously this is a film that can have a lot of mistakes happen throughout it. We've seen those mistakes in past films that kind of deal with similar concepts, like the Banana Splits movie and Willy's Wonderland. Now, what's funny about both of those movies is I think there's great things in both of them. The Banana Splits movie has disgusting kills and gore throughout. Willy's Wonderland has that comedic aspect that's so funny and hilarious with actually good animatronic characters as opposed to whatever the hell is going on in the Banana Splits movie. You take both of those things, you smush them into one movie, boom! You have yourself a good animatronic killer robot movie. And I think this film has the potential to do that. They've been literally trying to write this screenplay since 2015, so if it's not good, if the writing isn't good, I don't know what to tell you. What do you all think about the Five Nights at Freddy's movie, though? Are you excited for it? Are you, like, kind of concerned that all these studios saw these screenplays for the movies and were like, nope? Leave me something about it in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching my new video on the Five Nights at Freddy's movie. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more horror content. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok. Just look up Killjoy Jake and I'll come up. Check out my second channel, Movie Smoothie, where I review everything that isn't horror. I have content coming there as soon as I have like a little break in the action with all the horror content that's been coming out lately. I'm gonna start doing like a lot edgier content there instead of like just like doing news updates. I wanna post like just like personal opinions of mine on movies over there. So make sure to check that out by going to my little channels tab here, and it, like, there's a little link for that, and hopefully you subscribe. Also, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Just $1 a month goes a long way. Check that out by clicking on the link in the description below. Thank you all again for watching, and as always, don't forget to kill it out there, y'all.